Engineering and HOD of Computer Science Engineering to have a brief introduction about our today's presenter.
Yeah. To Dr. Satish.
Yes.
I'm very happy to introduce my PhD supervisor and today's expert speaker, Professor P. Krishna Reddy, the pioneering researcher in the field of IT for agriculture in this country. Professor P. Krishna Reddy is a faculty member at IIIT Hyderabad. He is the head of Agricultural Research Center and the member of Data Sciences and Analytics Center research team at IIIT Hyderabad. He has received both M.Tech and Ph.D. degrees in computer science from Jawaharlal Nehru University, New Delhi in 1991 and 1994, respectively. His research areas include data mining, database systems, and IT for agriculture. He has published about 145 refereed research papers, which include 17 journal papers, 3 book chapters, and 4 edited books. During 2013 and 2015, he has served as Program Director, ITRA Agriculture and Food Information Technology Research Academy, Government of India. From 1997 to 2002, he was a research associate at the Center for Conceptual Information Processing Research, Institute of Industrial Science, University of Tokyo. From 1994 to 1996, he worked as a faculty member in Netaji Subhas Institute of Delhi. During the summer 2003, he was a visiting researcher at Institute for Software Research International, School of Computer Science, Carnegie Mellon University, Pittsburgh, USA. He organized many conferences, international conferences. He was the preceding chair of COMAT 2008, a workshop chair of KDRS 2010, media and publicity chair of KDD 2015, and general chair of BDA 2017. He has organized the prestigious 14th Pacific Asia Conference on Knowledge Discovery and Data Mining, popularly called as PAKDD 2010, and the 3rd National Conference on Agroinformatics and Precision Agriculture 2012, and the 5th International Conference on Big Data Analytics. Professor P.K. Reddy, sir, has delivered several invited talks at the reputed conferences and workshops in India and abroad. Professor P.K. Reddy, sir, has got several awards and recognitions. He is a steering committee member of Pacific Asia Knowledge Discovery and Data Mining Conference Series and Database Systems for Advanced Application Conference Series. Professor P.K. Reddy, sir, is also a steering committee chair of Big Data Analytics Conference Series. He has made key contributions in data mining and database systems. Also, he has been investigating the building of efficient agricultural knowledge transfer systems by extending developments in IT. Professor P.K. Reddy, sir, has developed eSAGU technology and implemented in hundreds of villages. He has also built eAgromet system, which is an IT-based agrometeorological advisory system to provide risk mitigation information to farmers. Professor P.K. Reddy, sir, has conceptualized the notion of virtual crop lab to improve applied skills for extension professionals. Currently, he is investigating the building of question support system for farmers with the funding support from Indian-Japan Joint Research Laboratory Program. Professor P.K. Reddy, sir, has received 2 best paper awards. The eSAGU system has got several recognitions, including CSI Nigiland e-Governance Project Award in 2006 and Mandan Award in 2008, and the finalist in the Stockholm Challenge Award 2008. Okay, such a professor is with us now to deliver his talk on crop Darpan. I'm happy to inform you that I worked as a research scientist in this laboratory, eSAGU, during 2004 to 2010. Thank you, Ananda. Thank you. Over to Dr. Satish.
Yeah.
Hello. Now I would like
Hello. To yeah, Satish, shall I?
Yes, yeah. Yes, sir. Continue, please.
Okay. Thank you very much for kind introduction, Professor Raghunathan. So I think I'm going to share whatever we have developed after you left, actually, IIIT. You have to appreciate the progress we have made after you left. I hope you will appreciate. But anyway, so also thanks Dr. Satish for organizing this talk, and also thanks SRM University for organizing this talk. The title of my talk is towards building a smartphone-based system for improving the efficiency of every farm in India. Actually, the title not surprising, but the only thing is that we want to serve every farm in India. So you can ask the question now, are we serving every farm of India? So are we serving, are we providing actionable knowledge to every farm of India in a regular manner? The answer is no. As of now, we are not providing. But there is a smartphone revolution, as well as artificial intelligence revolution, machine learning revolution, data science revolution that are taking place. Now, we are in a position to build actionable knowledge delivery systems to improve the efficiency of every farmer in India. So in this talk, I'm going to share the experiences of my experiences of developing such systems to serve every farm of India, and also expose you with some of the research problems we have to solve in future. Yes, mate. Yeah. The presentation outline is as follows. Just a minute, I will move here. Okay, this is not going, this one. Okay, so the presentation outline is as follows. First, I will motivate you with some of the research problems with a few slides. I hope after these slides, everybody will have some research problem to solve. It will take about 5 minutes. After that, I will explain the systems I have built, prototype systems I have built over the last 20 years, starting with ESAGO. Then after that, village level ESAGO. It was a refinement of ESAGO. Based on the experiences of ESAGO and village level ESAGO, we are now building a crop Darpan system. It is a smartphone-based crop diagnostic tool. The prototype is already available on the web for rice and cotton crops. After that, I'm going to pose you some research problems, about 10 research problems, I think so, so that we all together can work and solve, again, build systems to improve the farming. So Crop Darpan can be accessed here, www.cropdarpan.com. You can also download Crop Darpan app through Android phone or Apple phone. Just type Crop Darpan on the Android and you will get it. You can download, you can start using it. For next half an hour, 45 minutes, then if you have any doubts, we can talk. So overall, my research area spans in three areas. One is I started working in database systems during my PhD. After that, I moved to data science area, data mining, web mining, bio mining. And after joining IIIT in 2002, I started working on IT in agriculture. So investigating issues in developing systems by extending information technology developments into agriculture. I'm also starting projects to improve the efficiency of legal systems by extending IT. So these are some key ideas developed. You can visit my website and know about my research area. Basically, it is informed that I am from the data science background. My area is BTech electronics, MTech computer science, PhD computer science. I also had a postdoc experience in Tokyo for about 5 years. So if you see this one, this year development, this indicates actually percentage of population earning less than $1.9 per day. You see, in India, this is the kind of thing, US and Canada and America are rich countries, and Russia, Japan are rich countries. Then Africans are poor countries. This is statistics, but let us talk about India. In India, 20% earn less than $2. And 90% earn less than $5. This is average one. means there are a lot of people who are earning even less than dollar also. Overall, this less earning is leading to all kinds of problems India is facing. If you earn less, you don't go to school. You don't complete 10th class, 7th class, 12th class. As a result, you don't get skills. As a result, you don't get employment. As a result, you don't eat well. And you will be malnutrition. You suffer from malnutrition problems and health problems. The main challenge before you and me and everybody, so we can think innovatively, is that how to bring the population out of poverty. That is the objective of government also. So we are researchers, and some of you are might be entrepreneurs, some of you are students. Everybody should make our effort, build systems to provide services to bring population out of poverty. So one of the opportunities is that everyone has a smartphone. That is a recent development over last decade. And the capabilities of smartphone are increasing. Bandwidth is increasing, capability is increasing, cost is decreasing. And one of the dimensions you can work is, you can work smartphone-based mobile systems. So another thing is here is that, I'll move here. This is opportunity. One of the research opportunity for those researchers who are doing research in India is that we can investigate the building of systems by extending IT to all livelihood technologies. On the left side, there are livelihood technologies which are there for centuries together, you know. It was there in the BC also. What are these technologies? Agriculture technology, education methodology, medical technologies, artisan technologies, employment generation, resource distribution, and efficient governance. Then these are the characteristics of our rural population. Rural and urban poor, uneducated farmers, unemployed youth, undernourished people having little incomes. Before that, we were trying to make efforts, even political systems, then systems ruled by kings. They are trying to push these technologies to population and with some success. If you are a good king, they used to do well. But under democratic governments also, we are making efforts, but there are some limitations. You can see all kinds of issues Indian society is suffering. The new opportunity is that these ICTs, information communication technologies, provide a new opportunity. What are the ICTs? Whatever you learn during BTech, computer science, internet, mobile network, decision support system, database systems, parallel access, online access, information service framework, cloud, big data, machine learning, whatnot, IoT is everything. The research issue is here is that, can we use these technologies to improve the performance of these livelihood technologies and corresponding delivery systems? If you think carefully, then you can have a lot of ideas. Yes. Think, lot of ideas. So how to do that? There are some domain experts in livelihood technologies. There might be domain expert in education technology, domain expert agriculture technology. You are expert in computer science. You have to talk to them. You have to understand their research papers. You have to understand their workflows. Then you have to explain them what are the capabilities of ICT-based systems. Then you should work together. I'm sure if you make this effort, you are going to definitely find one of the research issues. The question is, I fill this bottom box with only ICTs. You can fill this box with mechanical technologies, chemical technologies, civil engineering technologies, instrumentation technologies, and whatnot. I hope if you use this framework, I'm sure that Everybody can have a one PhD problem. Everybody can have one startup idea. Ultimately, if all work together and build systems, I hope we can solve these right side problems. So now, I was enthused by one of the paper written by Korth 20 years back. The research issue was that, what is the research agenda of database researchers for next 20 years? He said, one of the research agenda should be creation of personal information systems. 20 years back, he said that, imagine that a person will have a personal information device which can access internet at any time. Then, if everybody on this earth has such a device, what kind of systems you are going to build to bring profit to him or her? Now it is reality. Everybody has a smartphone, assume that it is going to happen. Now the research issue is that what kind of systems we are going to build to improve the, you know, to improve, to benefit to each and every individual. So again, so it is a very big problem. So I posed a question by saying is that for a farmer, what kind of system we have to build to benefit him? So I said that let us build a system to provide personalized advice, farm specific advice to every farm. With that motivation, I started. Then this is a research problem I posed. Suppose imagine a farmer in India who owns 2 to 3 acres. He might be literate or having a little bit literacy. What he wants, what he or she want, need water for each farm. So government, it is a political problem. Government should make to harvest water and provide water to each farm. Need finance for each farm. Government should make efforts to provide finance to each farm through banking and other investments. I said that every farm of India needs some knowledge to reduce crop failure and low income risk. So the question is that every farm needs a specific knowledge, because every farm is a 2 to 3 acres. Imagine a farmer has 10 fields, each having a one red soil, black soil kind of thing. So, but are we delivering knowledge to every farm? The answer is not. If you see clearly, since independence, we have started ICR labs, agriculture universities, departments of agriculture. They have got a valuable knowledge. They know what kind of steps a farmer has to take if he faces the problem. Unfortunately, such actionable knowledge is not reaching in a timely manner to each and every farm. So overall, the analogy is that we do not have knowledge canals for each farm for flowing knowledge like water. The existing systems are generalized and pull-based. So you got a call centers, you got a website. They expect that farmer will call, farmer will pull the information. So the main issue is that we have agriculture knowledge dams and we have agriculture knowledge dams. I call this agriculture universities, research labs as agriculture knowledge dams, but we do not have knowledge canals. The research question was how to build a knowledge canal to deliver actionable knowledge to each farm in a regular manner. Every 10 days knowledge should go. So if you ask that, you know, what kind of question this is? Is it a research problem? Is it possible to build a system to deliver knowledge to every farm of India? Whether we need such a research project across India? But if you see other domains, government is already making efforts to provide literacy to everybody. We are having a major schooling system, skill to everybody. Skill development program is going on. Employment to everybody. 100 days employment program is going on. Mahatma Gandhi Rural Employment Guarantee Program. Road connection to everybody, drinking water to everybody. this notion of personalization is happening in the areas of literacy, skill, health, employment, all other areas. What I'm saying is that why can't we develop a system across India to serve every firm with actionable knowledge in a timely manner? And I'm going to end up this talk. I'm going to show you that it is much cheaper than running the schooling system or Mahatma Gandhi Rural Employment Guarantee Program. It's much, much cheaper, actually. That's what I did. Last 20 years, I developed prototypes and shown a proof of concepts. So providing knowledge to each firm, what will happen by providing knowledge to each firm? It will create multiplier effect. It will improve water and finance utility. It will benefit poor and marginal farmers. Especially it will help small landholding farmers and illiterate farmers. And if you see carefully, the communication is not a problem. The research question is how to build a system to deliver actionable knowledge to each farm. So in this connection, so I started research in 2002. I have built two systems, ESAGU and village level ESAGU. And also I'm currently building Crop Darpan based on the experiences of ESAGU and village level ESAGU. I'm going to quickly share the experiences of these three systems. ESAGU means e-cultivation. Sagu means Telugu word cultivation. So we kept the ESAGU name. So I said that in 2002, how to build a system to serve every farm of India. I said that the system I'm going to build should serve every farm. It should provide farm-specific agro advice to each farmer to the farmer doorstep. It should provide advice within 36 hours. The advice should be provided every 10 days. That is the difference. Actually, a slip should go to each farmer regarding each of his farm, what kind of steps he has to take to protect his farm. And also, even the slip should go without farmer asking a question. So even it should be feedback based. So next week advice should go delivered based on the feedback of previous advice. So we have all kinds of advantages by employing IT, record keeping, availability, reliability. So we have developed this system. So what is the basic idea? The basic idea is as follows. In the medical domain, doctor examines black and white X-ray and detect the human health problem. In agriculture domain, why can't agriculture expert examine color photographs and detect the crop health problems? This question was posed in 2002. Based on this idea, we built the ESAGU system. In this system, agriculture scientist does not visit the crop. Crop photos are brought to agriculture expert. As a result, agriculture expert can utilize the time efficiently, spend less time to provide the advice, also can work during the night, especially human scientist is very advantageous. So somebody will capture the photograph, you are going to deliver expert advice. I shared all my ideas in this journal paper by Current Science. Who will send the photographs? The farmers can send the photographs. Difficult to implement as several farmers are illiterate and cannot send photographs. But we employed some educated, experienced farmers in each village as coordinators and asked them to send the photographs of illiterate farmers. We'll answer all the questions at the end. Okay. So this is the overall ESAGU main center, Agriculture Expert Agriculture Information System. This is the ESAGU local center. For coordinator house in the village can be a local center. He has got a laptop and camera. Each coordinator will manage certain farms. This is the protocol. Operational procedure is as follows. Farmer is registered. This is as a part of funding from Government of India we implemented. Coordinator registered the farmer by collecting soil, water, capital, and crop details. And so this one-time registration form he registers, he provides, and it is stored in the server. Once in 10 days, the coordinator visits the farm and collects the problematic photographs and fills in crop observation form, take the scan of that observation form, uploads it. Then agriculture experts see these photographs and type the expert advice what to do. And this expert advice is sent to the farmer within 24 hours. A slip goes to that farmer of that farm. The only change is that if coordinator visits certain farm on Monday, after 7 days or 10 days, he has to visit that farm, collect the photograph. In this way, every farm was visited regularly once in 10 days, and photographs are captured and advice was provided. So this is the typical, you know, prototype, you see. So first, I imagine that you are an agricultural scientist. You are seeing this photograph. So we are going to see the first photograph, this one. It's a zooming of how this typical cotton crop. I imagine that I am a scientist, I am visiting the, seeing the, you are a scientist and you are seeing the photograph. This is a zooming, it comes like this, cotton crop. Second one is this one. Zooming, you can see that clearly. So after implementing this project, we came to know that zooming facilities can be used as a microscope to observe the crop properly. Okay, it's much better. So even it is as though you are looking the crop through microscope. Third is stem. This stem is becoming black. This is a photograph of you know, feedback form. Stem is becoming black. Farmer is thinking that farmer has applied three acres urea in 3 acres, and that's why stem is becoming black. This is the farmer's perception. Some weeding is going on. He scribbles and uploads it. By seeing all these three photographs and everything, the agriculture expert typed the following advice. It is not due to fertilizer application. The root rot disease. To control these, pour copper oxychloride, Blytax, 3 grams per liter, or carbendazim, bavistin, 1 gram per liter solution at the base of the infected plant immediately. There is another advice called mix 2 kg trichoderma formulation in 50 kg FIM and put in the field. Tell the farmer to apply 75 kg potash in 3 acre land as early as possible. So this kind of advice goes in Telugu language within 24 hours to that farmer for that farm. Such kind of advice repeatedly goes every 10 days. So this is the system we develop. And also another kind of advice, you see, these are photographs of, you know, rice farm. So the agricultural scientist sees brown plant hopper, sheath blight and neck blast. This for brown plant hopper spray ethofen frogs, 300 milliliter imidacloprid kind of advice. Sheath blight, do this one, hexaconazole kind of advice. Neck blast, as the incident is low, no need to spray. This kind of advice goes to every farm every 10 days. So these are some of the photographs. Then we also implemented a prototype for fish ponds, where a fish coordinator take the photograph of fish by catching them, sample of fish and photograph of gills and skin and pond. And we experimented, they also worked efficiently. So fish coordinator goes to the pond and collect this data, like a pH value, salinity, depth, and all kinds of form. He has to take fish and catch fish and with boatman and take the gills and pond photographs like this. So the problem is flukes and reddish at the starting stage. This is typed by fish scientists. Apply BKC 80% half liter per acre, supplement endofloxacin 0.5 gram per kg of feed. This is another experience, again, second advice for fish. System to trichodina, ask the farm to apply 1.5 liter per acre, ask to reduce the feed for 3-4 days. So it was also very effectively implemented. I'm not discussing about fish system, I gave a hint actually. Overall, we implemented ESOG system about 5 to 6 years with the funding from especially Government of India, Nokia at the time, Government of Andhra Pradesh, and several agencies, private companies, collaborated with the Janani and all companies. And overall, it proved that the system was very effective. It was benefiting the farmer significantly. For example, for cotton farmer, per acre, we are getting 4,900 additional benefit by saving 1 bag of fertilizer, by saving about 2.5 pesticide sprays. We conducted impact evaluation studies, and also gaining 1.5 quintal of cotton extra. Similarly, chelli, more advice, more benefit because of due to sale price is more per quintal of chelli. We implemented on thousands of cotton farms across Andhra Pradesh, including Khammam, Anantapur for groundnut crop, even Mahabubnagar for castor crop, even Rangareddy for red gram crop, even Bhimaram for rice crop, Patepuram for fish, even Warangal for cotton, Kammam for chili. So we have done wide experiments and proved that the system can work for all kinds of crops, including horticulture crops. So this was very excellent system. Overall, the summary of ESAGO system is as follows. It is encouraging IPM, integrated pest management, because we are providing every 10 days. It is provided by agriculture expert. And judicious use of pesticides and fertilizers. We are not saying no to fertilizer. We are not saying yes to fertilizer. We are saying whenever it is required, apply the fertilizer pesticide judiciously and avoid indiscriminate usage. Benefit is significant. Agriculture expert can deliver about 100 advices per day. That was our experimental result. Within 24 hours, we can reach the farmer. And we also charge it for the farmers, and farmers like this advice. Now, that system was excellent. And now also, if India wants to go for export-oriented farm products, we have to follow ESAGO. We have to monitor every farm. That is only option. I'm seeing a lot of systems which have been developed, which will not work. ESAGO is the only option if you are doing a business to export the farm products. Implement ESAGO. Ensure that you don't have pesticide residues, fertilizer residues in the farm produce. Everybody liked the ESAGO system. Now also it has become an example system to follow. Now after that, we developed village level ESAGO to make it more cost effective to serve all the farmers, including poor farmers. So the observation was that ESAGO benefited all kinds of crops, cotton and chilies, mango kind of crops more, and cereals, pulses less. So then, overall, I got a feedback from several stakeholders saying that, sir, why don't you develop another system which is more cost effective? Let ESAG will be implemented by those industries who need export-oriented farm produce or some farmer produce organizations. So we said that, let us develop another system to just versatile system which will benefit everybody and serve all the crops. So this system name is Village Level ESAG. The objective was it should be accessible to poor farmers throughout the year, should cover all the crops, should not compromise on personalization, should be affordable, scalable, should encourage community discussion, should encourage knowledge empowerment. This was not happening in the ESAGO. Now the village level ESAGO is going to happen. One physical notice board is put in each village. Coordinator is equipped with computer, internet, color printer, motorbike. We formed the cluster of 5 villages and which formed a global village. For each cluster, we selected a sample farms. We identified 30 sample farms, 5 sample farms for each crop. For example, cotton, northeast, soil variety, 5 sample farms. In this way, top 5 crops, 30 farms for 25 farms and 1 sample farm for other crop, 30 crops for 30 farms were selected. These 30 farms are visited by coordinator every week, once in a week or once in 10 days. Then photographs are sent to the agriculture expert. Agriculture expert will type the advice by seeing the photographs. The color photographs and the advice is printed and pasted in the village level notice boards. We told the farmer that, okay, if you are a farmer in the village, we conducted a big meeting. You visit the notice board and see the photographs. If you are facing the similar problem lies in photographs, follow this advice. And these advice sheets are changed every 10 days throughout the year. So this is the thing actually. So whenever photographs are changed, sheets are changed, the notice board, SMS is sent to all the farmers in the village. So in this way, the system is implemented over 3 years, about hundreds of villages. So farmer has to see the notice board and see the photographs. If he is cultivating some cotton crop, you see the cotton photograph. If he is facing the same problem, you have to follow the advice. So this is the kind of typical notice board. These are advice sheets we develop. This is the brinjal advice sheet, you see. So brinjal photograph. And advice is for the control of stem and foot borer, apply 3 grams of carbonyl, 50% or spray profenofox, like that. So these kind of Brinjal, you see, this sheet will be displayed in the notice board. So similarly, Mej kind of thing. Okay. Similarly, paddy advice, paddy sheet, banana sheet, chili sheet, the mango sheet in Telugu, we are doing. We implemented in several KVKs actually. This is our one of the photographs. This is the final notice board. You see, BDL sponsored this project for 1 year. And this is a notice board. Farmer will see the photographs and see the whether his crop is facing the same problem. You can copy this advice. Everything is in Telugu. The lock and lock. These sheets are changed every 10 days. So this is the typical, you know, some are more farms than two notice boards are used. Sometimes you are pasting on the walls also. So there are different number of crops are more than the size of the notice board. So this system, what is happening? If you are an agriculture expert, you are in effectively visiting every farm every 10 days. Farmers are saying, see, this is implemented by Paras Electronics for 3 years. They funded about project for about 30 villages for 3 years under CSR. We implemented and tested that. This is working very effectively. Now, this is, I'll come to ESAGU system. ESAGU is 100% push-based system. This is 80% push, 20% pull. And also, farmers can see photographs. They can discuss each other. And they can exchange communication. They can also learn. So they can empower themselves. They can share the knowledge. So we observed that farmers are seeing the face of the agriculture expert through notice board. So how many scientists are there in agriculture? Good scientists are there in agriculture. We can create a virtual scientist to every village through this system. It is much cheaper actually, because one coordinator can cover 20 villages. One scientist can cover 200 villages. So how many scientists you need for any state? Number of villages by, you know, 200. Number of villages in your state by 200. If you provide a little bit, if you support scientists and coordinator cost, the cost is much cheaper. As a result, we can create a village level knowledge canal, actionable knowledge canal, village level to every village of India. So with this, what will happen? Whatever the actionable knowledge, new inventions produced by agriculture area can be pushed to this canal, can reach the farmers. This is the system that can be scaled. Technology is available. If anybody is interested, they can come and contact me. So I can provide the cost also. Now, this two technologies are ready. One is ESAGU system, which can be used to develop export-oriented farm products. And village-level ESAGU system, which will provide knowledge to every farm of India, including poor and marginal farmers. And notice board can be exploited to create a business model through advertisement, everything. That is not an issue. Anyway, two systems are built and implemented in hundreds of villages, and proof of concept is already proved that they are good, actually. The third system I'm building now, I already built, is Crop Darpan system. So what happened was that 4 years back, we have started Indo-Japan joint project in agriculture. The title of this project is Data Science-Based Farming Support System for Sustainable Crop Production Under Climate Change. I was asked to innovate next generation knowledge transfer system. So by employing smartphone, as a part of this effort, we have built this Crop Darpan system. So again, the question now is that, again, same problem, how to build a tool to help every farm of India. I have built ESAG system, but it was not scaling. Village level ESAG system, technology was there, but can we develop further? System, a better system by exploiting latest smartphone technology. So overall, the existing system can be categorized into, across India, categorized into pull-based system, like call center, knowledge portals. So you are pulling knowledge, okay? So they assume that your farmer will pull the knowledge. Example is farmer, call centers assume that you can pose a question. Knowledge portals assume that you go to access website and access it. Another push-based system, ESAGU farm level system we built. And the farmers are liking, but the worry is high, so all farmers may not follow because the cost will become high. But if you want to create a business, you can follow ESAGU system. hybrid system, the village level system, push and pull be implemented, but still, what happened that they are seeing the advice in the notice boards, village level system, they are asking, they are calling again. It means that they are saying, sir, we have shown the photographs on the notice board and we are facing the similar problem. Please tell the pesticide vendor what kind of pesticide he has to give. With this, we understood that farmer is able to see the crop and compare the crop with the photographs. Can we exploit that capability and build a next generation system by exploiting smartphone? So the motivation of Crop Darpan is village level ISAGU. The motivation of village level ISAGU is ISAGU, farm level system. So it is a continuous progress. So in future, most of the farmers will have high-end mobile phones with internet connectivity and increase the number of educated farmers, because that's going to happen. So how about building a smartphone application to guide the farmer to identify the field problem, get the solution? So in this system, the farmer poses a smartphone and visits the farm. After seeing the risk or an problem in person, the farmer uses the tool to identify the crop problem. After identifying the problem, he and she can get the advice from Crop Darpan or contact any scientist or call center. The advantages are, farmer is able to form a question for his or own crop problem. The farmer is fully empowered. He need not depend on others. Also, he can learn. He can learn from this tool. That is the objective. So then I am a data scientist, I told you already. We search some related ideas. One is concept of generalization. Generalization is an object abstraction which enables the class of individual objects to be thought of generically as a single named object. So this is the database research. For example, a typical vehicle can be an air vehicle, land vehicle, water vehicle. Air vehicle can be plane or helicopter. Plane can be passenger aircraft and air freighter. Suppose there is some vehicle on the road you want to identify, you can call the friend. What is the name of this vehicle? The friend will ask question based on this hierarchy. Oh, is it an air vehicle? Is it a land vehicle? Is it a water vehicle? If you say yes, then is it a plane, helicopter? So plane has some features. You can say that, okay, helicopter has such things. So would you see some fans or something like that? So by enabling questions, we can categorize the vehicle. The another question, 20 question game kind of technology. We play this game from the childhood. So in the room, you ask opposite person, imagine some object, then you start posing questions to him. Is it round or square? Is it color is what that? In this way, you are going to remove all other options. Finally, you are going to identify the object. This is another technology. The third is an important technology we are going to exploit in the building Crop Darpan system. This is visual recognition common loop. This is a machine learning based system. This is a research paper. So here, the left side chair or aeroplane, if you ask, you can easily say. All existing machine learning systems, artificial intelligence systems are good at this kind of problem. If you very diverse and specific, you know, features, they can easily identify. If you say human being and some other animal, it will say this is the human being, this is the animal. But if you say finch or bunt, this is a bird, this may be a finch bird or bunt bird. This can be a finch bird or bunt bird. But the existing artificial intelligence systems are unable to detect clearly. Machine learning systems are unable to detect clearly. But if you ask this question, yellow belly or blue belly, it is easy to detect, because belly you are seeing the feature. The question is, divide this object into features, ask the feature-based questions and classify this object. For example, is it a belly white? Yes. Are the eyes white? Yes. The bird is a parakeet auklet. Is the beak cone shape? Yes. Is the upper tail brown? Yes. In this way, you can pose the question, then you can classify this bird as some kind of sparrow. So it means that if you see some object, you can pose feature level questions and ask somebody to confirm. Then you can classify the object. So we are going to follow same techniques. So then we try to have some field study whether farmers can understand the crop problem. So we did some experiment. We took the farmer to the field, asked them to identify the crop problem. and we took the photographs and we shown the photographs to agriculture expert, and then we compared the names, identify agriculture expert with the farmers names. So you see all the cotton farmers are identifying like this. They never identify the problem name. They only identify the features actually. Okay. So unless you have problem name, you can't ask pesticide from the pesticide shop. So point is that these features have to be converted into pesticide, the problem name. In the for problems on rice, all kinds of features only farmers can identify. They are unable to identify the name of the problem. So after this field study, the following lessons have been learned. Crop suffers from several problems. A field problem is a combination of set of visual perceptions. Both farmers and agriculture scientists can provide a visual symptom to each problem. But the difference is that farmer identifies the crop problem with general visual appearances. So several problems mapped to one general visual appearance. But agriculture scientists identify the crop problem with specialized visual appearances. So this is the one example I will show you. For example, farmer sees the problem as a leaf curl, feature a leaf curl. But scientists will classify the white fly, aphid, thrips, mealybug, jaw seeds, leaf curl virus, zinc deficiency. So for white fly to happen, the following features should be yes. Leaf curling should be one, presence of insect should be one, insect color white should be one, leaf discoloration should be one, discoloration of scattered irregular should be one, black sooty growth one. Similarly, aphids, some other features should be one. The observation is that these are the things that are observed by scientists, but these can be converted into questions. Even though farmer doesn't know name of the question, but if you pose this question to the farmer, he is able to say yes or no. The research problem was that how to convert this into questions, render systematically to the farmers. So the farmer can see the crop in the smartphone, through the smartphone, and say yes by observing the crop physically. Then based on yes or no decisions, can we classify it as a white fly, aphid, and thrips? This is the basic idea. So these are some photographs actually. I'm going to answer all the doubts. Just type the questions in the SMS or the messaging. I'm going to answer all the doubts. So aphids, thrips, mealybug, these are the visual perceptions actually. So the question is that being semi-literate, the farmer is able to identify the generalized visual perceptions of the crop. The lower level visual perceptions of the field problems of the given crop can be collected from subject matter specialists. This is the basic idea of crop darpan. The crop darpan contains the hierarchy of visual perceptions of the field symptom that consists of generalized, middle level, and lower level perceptions. The crop darpan helps the farmer to identify the field problem by confirming the corresponding low level perceptions and obtain agro advice. This is the name of the tool, crop darpan. We developed data collection protocols and rendering protocols. Basically, we extended the data science techniques, association rules, coverage patterns, concept hierarchy, question answering framework, decision trees, database system, pattern mining techniques, perception engineering. We combined all the ideas and developed the tool. This crop darpan can be accessed from here, cropdarpan.com. So you can download crop darpan from the website and Play Store. Let me see. So how to go back to my site? So I will develop this one. So I don't know how to go to my, I want demo, but anyway, so you can see that one. So this is the kind of Telugu advice. So Telugu, you may not understand. So this is, see, if you go to the field, mobile phone, you can select the paddy, you can say English. And you can, these kind of questions are posed to the, through farmer. So high level questions. Do you observe seedling problem? Do you observe problem in leaves? Do you observe problem in stem? Do you observe any presence of insects? Do you observe problem in panicle grains? So high level. So if your crop is suffering any problem, it should be in one of these problems. Okay. Suppose farmer sees that he has a problem in the leaves and clicks yes. Then the next level question is posed. Then the sub-level question, do you observe any spots on leaves? Do you observe any discoloration of leaves? Do you observe any streaks on leaves? If say yes, then another question, these are the question, third level question will be posed. Do you observe any spindle shaped spots with brown margin with grayish center? If you say yes, this is the leaf blast, this is the advice, and all kinds of things will come. Photographs also will come now. I have not kept in the slides, but you can see the tool, photographs are displaying. We are displaying photographs also. So we developed the RISE for considering 37 problems. So these are the things that are happening here. So you start with paddy, leaves, you can follow. After seeing the leaf problem, you can follow this path on this path. So you can see, you know, paddy, panicle grains, fully chaffy grains, brown chaffy grains like this. Then paddy, in this way, these are the some trees we have that are going to happen. These are paths from the root to the leaf actually. So everything we display the path. Similarly, cotton. So cotton, for example, you are going to see, do you find any damage on leaves? Do you observe any stem damage? Do you find any damage on flowers? If you say yes, is there a delay in blooming? If you say yes, then phosphorus deficiency. Simple, you have to answer a few questions by seeing the crop and you will find your own problem. So if you have multiple problems, use the tools multiple times. This Telugu, I'm not going to discuss. Again, you see what is the first flower damage question. It is branching out various sub problems in this way, tool. In this way, it is branching out. These are the trees that are branching out when that is happening. Now, next few minutes, I'm going to explain you few future research problems, how to build similar systems in other areas. So these systems are farm-specific sowing timing decision helper, farm-specific crop suitability recommender, farm-specific harvesting decision helper, farm-specific irrigation scheduling advisor, farm-specific crop health advisory system. Other systems are tank-specific crop scheduler, farmer-specific crop planner, crop-specific price prediction system, crop-specific price and disease alert system. I'm briefly explaining this. For example, farm-specific sowing timing decision helper. The research problem is that farmers make a mistake of sowing without having a knowledge of onset of monsoon, required moisture in the soil for sowing, realized rainfall, and expected rainfall in future. In that case, from the farmer, we should take date of the query, place of the query, soil type, name of the crop. Then our recommendation is that whether to go for sowing or not. This is for all farms of India, all farmers of India, all crops of India. Okay, so problem is very huge actually. Similarly, farm specific crop suitability recommender. Given the field, the objective is to develop a DSS to help the farmer with the possible crop alternatives. Farmer make a mistake of sowing wrong crop in the wrong soil, given soil. He or she doesn't know alternatives. The question is, farmer will put a query, place of the query and soil type. The farmer should be recommended with appropriate crop types, including latest varieties for all, again, across India. Similarly, a farm-specific harvesting decision helper. So to help the decision support system, to develop the decision support system for farming-specific harvesting advice. Sometimes farmers make a mistake of harvesting also because of due to climate. So the input is date of query, place of the field, date of sowing, name of the crop, expected harvest date. The output is that whether you should harvest or not. This is a location-specific advice, okay? Crop-specific advice. Again, farm-specific irrigation scheduling advisor to develop a decision support system to help the farmer whether to give water to the field or not. Farmer do not consider the water efficiency that much. So we are going to save the water with this. The input is date of sowing, crop name, soil name, water place, the previous date which the field was provided the water. The output to the farmer, suggestion to the farmer regarding when to apply water to the field. Similarly, crop health advisory system, I already developed actually farm specific. That's the same thing. That's what I did it. Other systems we can build. Given a tank, India consists of tanks. Given a tank and given a season, what kind of crop scheduling we should recommend so that the given given water in the tank is sufficient to harvest different kind of crops. So farmers should not make a mistake of cultivating rice crop even though the limited amount of water. So this is This will help corresponding collector and farmer or agriculture department. So today, so the input is tank, place of the tank, soil type, corresponding area, type of the crops. So output dynamic crop scheduling suggestion based on the realized and predicted weather. Another is farmer specific crop scheduler. Farmer also has a 10 to 20 acres of land. He can cultivate various crops. What crop he has to cultivate, what schedule he has to cultivate, given the water availability, rainfall and other things. This is also a problem. So input is farmer name, water source, soil types and corresponding area. The output dynamic crop scheduling suggestion based on realized and predicted weather. Similarly, crop specific market prediction system. The input is crop name, price trend during the next few months. The pest and disease alert system, sometimes, you know, some pests grow suddenly. So like a blast kind of thing. So we need such kind of advisory systems also. So overall, the systems I proposed, I built and I proposed are scalable. It is relevant to all crops. It will solve all the farmers, all the regions, all the countries. India is definitely, and also they are location specific, personalized, language specific, also dialectic specific. The point is that we have to go to that level. Otherwise, no, farmers will not follow. So overall, the crop darpan system has a potential to help poor, marginally illiterate farmers, touches and benefits every farming family, improves income of poor and marginal farmers, provides cost-effective opportunity to help the farmers. Overall, I summarize that it has the opportunity to create a next agriculture revolution. We have to come together. Agricultural scientists and computer scientists have to come together. We have to piggyback video, audio on the crop darpan help the farmers. It has also potential crowd computing application. Summary is that from big data and data science point of view, we have a scalable technologies. Storage cost is reducing. Processing power is cheap, high-speed network is available. What is required is that it is a coordinated effort from agricultural scientists and computer scientists and develop the systems. So in this talk, I will explain the example systems I have built, list of systems we have to build in future. All systems are, I told, are scalable. All crops, farmers, regions, countries, they are location-specific, personalized, language-specific, and dialectic-specific. With this, I close now. I think what to do, I'm not getting now. Just a minute. So you can, okay, so what to do? It is not coming. Hello, Satish, I stopped. Yes. My presentation is over. But okay. Somehow the screen is not going back to my computer, actually. I don't know.
There is one option called stop screen share, sir. At
okay.
The top. Thank
you. Okay.
Yeah,
thank
yes,
you.
Yes.
Now I thank got you for so the... let us.
Yes, yes.
Yeah. Please my presentation continue. Is over.
Okay, yeah. Sir. Thank you for the wonderful presentation, sir. On behalf of all farmers, I would like to deeply appreciate your effort and contribution in implementing the ESAGU and crop darpan in different types of farming. Before addressing the vote of thanks, I would like to read the question. And I mean, there are a few questions that was.
Yeah, I can see these questions. So, yes. First question is that our current PM Sri Modi ji is promoting smart agriculture, smart farming. Do you think that blockchain technology can gain trust of the small farmer on new platform developed by our government? What are the future scopes are here? My answer is no, actually. The first thing is that I'm a database researcher. I'm unsure how blockchain technology, it can support some technology, basically the security and trust area. And all trust problems can be solved using existing Oracle and database systems. I don't think blockchain technology is going to add additional significant advantage. It may have had some advantage. I don't think blockchain, I don't know. Actually, I don't think actually. My answer is no. Okay, next is, sharing link is okay. Somebody is doing. Why it is called ESAGU? Just we started a project and at that time the funding agency said that since he started from Andhra Pradesh, why can't we give a Telugu name? Actually, in the first presentation they gave Isagu, then we continued with Isagu. Sagu means cultivation in Telugu language. Okay. My question: whether you give advice on agrometal advice as well? If yes, then what you should take? Thanks so much, Professor Anupam Kumar from Ahmedabad. Agro met advice, whatever. So this system is a canal. Actually, in the introductory presentation slides, we are providing a knowledge canal. What to flow? What kind of knowledge should flow? Decided by agriculture experts. So if agriculture experts wants to provide agromet advice, they can provide. So when we implemented, we provided weather prediction to agriculture experts, and they by considering the weather prediction, by considering the agromet advice of IMD, they used to provide agromet advice also. I have attended your workshop by IDOS for workshop on high performance computing algorithm, where you presented building farm sizes to improve the uniformity. Especially your research on crop Darpan app and Isagu are inspired me a lot. Is there any possible way in one can contribute to your project? That's why we have to come together. Actually, now crop Darpan is built only for cotton and rice crops. Then we have to add voice, video. We have to extend animation technologies. We can extend, for example, artificial intelligence, dialogue systems. Plus, we have to extend to all crops of India. So it is a huge problem. One side is research refinement. Another side is scaling crop Darpan to other things. Let me complete all messages. I will come back to those participants who raised hands. Sir, is there a possibility to provide solution problem through voice message in their mother tongue so that even illiterate farmers who do not write even can understand? Yes. We are making efforts now. I think the next step is we are adding a voice to in our crop Darpan system. Thank you very much. I think our developers are also attending this session, and they will take your suggestion. Thank you. Can it also check soil quality? We have to discuss with the soil scientists. That is not happening. So the crop Darpan has been built by discussing with entomologist and pathologist. Now I have to discuss with the soil scientist and other physiologist also. Definitely it's going to check the quality, but we have to suggest some measures. Actually, we are going to investigate this issue. How can we enable the farmer to capture hyperspectral images of mustard seeds with his smartphone? That I don't know, because we don't know. Unless smartphone has the capability, how can we do it? Maybe Professor Adinarayana from IIT Bombay is doing this kind of research. I think you can contact him actually. IIT Bombay, Professor Adinarayana. What is your opinion on cotton plugging using AI? This is a little bit difficult question. And my opinion on AI, I explained in one slide. AI, artificial intelligence, for example, given a cotton crop, how many problems it is suffering? At least 30 to 40 problems. Each problem is a egg stage, larval stage, pupa stage, adult stage. You imagine how many photographs are needed to train this AI. And it's a huge thing. And this is for one problem. Given a time, a crop may face more than one problem, two, three problems. So whatever your AI application you develop, unless there's a human intervention, it is not fully successful actually. That is my opinion, actually. We can debate on this issue. Is there public database content crop disease picture and preventive recommendations? I think go see the crop Darpan tool, and we have provided two options. One is if you don't know the crop disease, it will take you one path. If you know the crop disease, it will provide all the database, actually. It is already there. Whether your team providing public image data set where various plant diseases can be studied. I don't think now that I need some research funding. I got images, but they have to tag, they have to categorize. I need some funding to do that. If you have some funding, and I can provide that data set to you. I require funding for curing that data set. Is there any way to get access to crop leaf data set in order to perform disease detection via deep learning? Yes. You contact me. I don't think it is. Lot of people tried. These photographs are collected by taking camera in the open field. These photographs are not collected for machine learning purpose. These photographs are collected to help the human being to take the decision. If it is helping for deep learning, I am willing to give photographs to you. Can there be specific risk mitigation farmer way from seed sourcing to commodity sale? Yes. For farmer all the way from seed. So yes. There are lot of farmer faces lot of risks. Climate risks, seed failure risks, fertilizer availability risk, water risk, all kinds of risk. There are lot of risk mitigation advices farmer needs actually. Farmer don't know. Most of the farmers go by intuition, their past experience. But if you couple with the scientific advice, we can bring a lot of benefit and save a lot of investment by the farmer. If any live questions, I want to take actually. Any live questions, somebody raise the hand. You can, Satish, you can ask them.
Students cannot able to speak, sir. They are having only access to type.
Yeah, ask them to type the advice then. Yeah. Type the question.
Mr. Chaitanya and Mr. Gnana Karthik, if you have any questions, please type in the question and answer session. There is a chat box down to the, just beside to the participants.
All the participants are asked to type the question. Then I can answer actually.
I think they left, sir.
Okay. Somebody is raising the hand, Hamad or somebody. I don't know whether he has answered. He has asked any question, whether I answered or not. I don't know.
Okay. Yes, sir.
Okay.
Now, I would like to request Dr. Ashok Pradhan to address the vote of thanks.
Thank you very much, Dr. Satish. So on behalf of Computer Science and Engineering Department, SRM University, AP, I would like to thank Professor P. Krishna Reddy from IIT Hyderabad for accepting our invitation to join us as a resource person in the second distinguished lecture series. Thank you so much, Professor, for spending your valuable time in giving a lecture titled Crop Darpan Towards Building a Smartphone-Based System for Improving the Efficiency of Every farm in India, and talk about eSegu system and IT-based farm-specific agro advisory system, and also discuss the various research issues related to this domain. I hope the students, colleagues, and the various participants will definitely get benefit by this wonderful lecture series. We are grateful to SR University management for the endless support received to organize this program. I thank Professor Raghunathan, HOD and Associate Dean of Engineering for all kind of support received from him. I'm thankful to Dr. Satish, one of the coordinator, to organize this event. I thank all my colleagues and participants once again for these sessions, IT Camp and Public Relations for supporting us to make this event successful. Thank you all.
Yeah, somebody raised the hand, ask Uma Vani to type a question.
Huh? Yeah. Miss Uma Vani, please type your question. Yes, sir. Our question is automatic irrigation system. Sir, what about the IoT-based solution for automatic irrigation system?
Yeah, so the question now, automatic irrigation system, so normally the issue is lying with the sensors actually, reliable sensors. Also, and for specific crops like mango and high revenue crops, it is possible. But mostly the sensor should be reliable and it should be perennial crops like a mango. It is possible actually. It is possible. And I think already companies are implementing it and you can study the existing technologies and research issues, research papers and try to come up with ideas to improve the things. Yeah. Okay.
Yeah. No questions from the attendees, then we'll be ending the session.
Okay, yeah, thank you. Thank you very much.
Sir, thank you, sir, for participating in this, actually. I mean,
so now, what do you think? Sir? We are reaching the eSegu to logical end now. So, crop Darpan system.
Yes, sir. Yeah.
Yes. So, smartphone. So, yeah. Thank you very much. And,
thank you, sir.
So, talk has come well or anything. So, it's okay now.
It was very nice, sir. Thank you.
Okay. Because we have, you know, 1 hour time, I have to cover 20 years of work actually. So, but anyway, so I gave some ideas they can explore if they want to investigate in details, they want to study details. Okay, thank you, Raghunathan, and thank you, Satish, and thank you, Dr. Ashok, and thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you.
Bye, sir.